Chapter 9, Clothes We Wear. The three basic needs of human beings are food, shelter, and clothes. Without food, we cannot survive, whereas shelter and clothes protect us from changing weather condition and many other things. Clothes are our need. People living in different parts of the country and the world wear different type of clothes depending upon the weather condition and the culture. Clothes protect us from cold, heat, rain, dust and insects. We wear woolen clothes in winter to protect ourselves from cold. In summer, we wear light cotton clothes which absorb sweat and protect us from the heat of the sun. We wear raincoat when we go out in the rain. A raincoat is made of waterproof material, thereby protecting us from the rain. Our clothes protect us from dust too. The dust settled on our clothes, we can see it on the collars and cuffs of our shirts and other clothes. Thus, our clothes form a protective layer between dust and our body. Similarly, they protect us from mosquitoes and other insect bites. Winter clothes, summer clothes, rainy season clothes. In ancient times, people used to cover their bodies with bark and big leaves of trees or animal skin and fur. Gradually, they learned to make fabric from fiber and stitch them into various type of dresses. Fibers and their types. We already know that cloth is made from fibers. Many fibers, when twisted together, make yarns. These yarns make fibers. One or more fabric are then stitched together to make different clothes. Fibers are of two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers, as the name suggested, the fiber obtained from nature are called natural fibers. These fibers are obtained from either plants or animals. Cotton, jute, flax and hemp are plant fibers. On the other hand, wool and silk are animal fibers. Shirt made of cotton, coat made of hemp, sweater made of wool, lehenga made of silk. Synthetic fiber. Synthetic fibers are man-made fibers and do not occur in nature. Nylon, rayon, lycra and polyester are some examples of synthetic fibers. These are prepared artificially and passes various qualities. They are waterproof, stretchable, wrinkle-free, etc. Synthetic fibers have their drawbacks also. They do not absorb sweat as they are waterproof and they catch fire easily. We can also identify the culture of a person from the clothes worn by him or her. Similarly, we can identify the profession, job of a person from his or her clothes. Clothes and culture. People wear different clothes depending upon the climate and culture tradition of the place they live in. For example, people of Jammu and Kashmir wear a thick long dress called firan. The traditional dress of Kerala consists of mundu and neriyathu. Some of these traditional clothes have become national dresses. Kimono is the national dress of Japan. Hanbok is that of Korea and sari is the national dress of women of India. Clothes and profession. People wear different clothes according to their job or profession. Lawyer wear black coats, doctors and nurses wear white coats and students wear their school uniform. Taking care of clothes. To look smart, neat and tidy, we should wear clean and well-ironed clothes. We should take proper care of our clothes to keep them in good condition for a long time. Clothes should be washed properly with a good quality detergent or soap. Colored clothes should be dried in shade, and white clothes should be dried in the sun. Woolen and silk clothes are very delicate. They should either be dry cleaned or washed with a mild detergent. While keeping woolen or silk clothes, mothballs or dried neem leaves should be kept in them. This helps to keep insects like silverfish and moths away. Cotton clothes should be ironed before wearing. We should mend clothes that are torn or have broken buttons before wearing them.